So the hot Big Bang model is widely accepted. So according to this model, our universe started very hot and very dense. During a first fraction of a second, our universe went through a phase of exponential expansion that we call inflation. Our universe till date is expanding. Our idea of Big Bang is not correct. The Big Bang happened everywhere at once. Few seconds after the Big Bang, baryonic matter came to existence. Baryonic matter include particles having three quarks, such as our protons and neutrons, which make up the nuclei of our atoms. After few minutes, atoms of light elements came to existence due to nucleosynthesis. Our universe was so hot back then that the atoms of these elements were in its ionized state. So our universe was a hot plasma of these nuclei and free electrons. The density of free electrons in the universe was very high. Photons were easily scattered due to a phenomena known as Thomson scattering. Due to this, photons could not travel long distances. Their mean free path was very small on astronomical scales. A mean free path means the distance traveled by a particle between two successful collisions. Due to this, the photons could not travel further enough and the universe was opaque. The universe remained in the plasma state until around 380,000 years after the Big Bang. At this moment, the universe had cooled enough due to its expansion that the free electrons combined with the ionized hydrogen to form neutral hydrogens and other similar lighter elements. At this moment, the density of electrons in the universe became low. As the density of the particles in the universe became low, so the mean free path of a photon became as large as the size of our universe.
There wasn't enough particles for the photons to collide with. Hence, they could travel freely and the universe became transparent.
Photons which were released during this recombination phase are the photons that we see from the cosmic microwave background radiation. Today, the wavelengths have stretched so much that we cannot observe them with naked eye as they have shifted to the microwave part of our spectrum. The CMB is also called the surface of last scattering.
To get the idea of CMB more clear in our heads, let's think about it in this way. Let's say on a day we are covered with fog which is so dense that we cannot see our own hand as we place our hand in front of our eye. This fog surrounds us in all directions till infinite distance. Let's say all this fog disappeared all at once. The same way, when the recombination happened, the universe became transparent. In this example, our surroundings became clear to us. The things that are closer to us will be visible to us first, then the things that are further away. But we can always see this fog at a distance. But this distance becomes larger and larger as the time passes, and it becomes more fainter and fainter as it goes away from us. This fog represents the CMB, surface of the last scattering. So this is it for today. If you have any suggestions, write us in the comments down below. If you want to check my channel on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, the links are in the description below. Like this video, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel for all the future videos. And as always, stay curious, stay awesome.